In this series of videos, we are going to talk about taking Numbrix puzzles and programming them in Python. And what we're going to actually be able to do in Python is create a little interactive console application for playing Numbrix puzzles that has these hints in it that we've been working on. So I wanted to start by showing you the Jupyter notebook you'll have to work with this week. The first thing we want to do is import something called the tkinter package. And that package is used for making an interface that we can interact with. So let's initialize that package. And I've taken a Numbrix puzzle from Parade Magazine, and I've input that as a list of lists. So that's the next step here. One of the things that I want to talk to you about first is why we would bother programming this in Python, because last week we spent some time making a sort of interactive Numbrix puzzle in Excel, and that was really nice. But one of the things that we had to do was make all of these different sheets in the background that were keeping track of things for us. And remember that one of Excel's strengths is in using very common tools that lots of people want to use. Excel is really great for if you have things that other people may have done before, but Numbrix puzzles are not super popular. I don't think that people are turning to Excel to do their Numbrix puzzles very frequently, so we had to teach a lot of things to Excel, and that's why we needed so many sheets working in the background. One thing that's nice about something like a programming language like Python is that we have the ability to teach it more, and then it can hold on to those things that we've taught it, and we can use all the functionality of this programming language. So to be a little bit more specific, we want to create a new data object. We want to think about a cell or an entry within a Numbrix puzzle as being its own entry. And there are properties of that cell that we need to use in the future. And all of these different properties were part of the tabs that we were using in Excel. So for example, when I think about a cell in a Numbrix puzzle, I think about that cell as having a position in the grid. So it has a row number and a column number. That cell has a value, which is the value that it takes on in the puzzle. And then that cell has a handful of adjacent values that influence what can and cannot be in that cell. So there's a left cell value, a right cell value, an up cell value, and a down cell value, where some of those things may or may not make sense based on if we're on an edge or corner, but we can still put them there as theoretical objects for the cell. And then each cell has a different cell, which would have coordinates in the puzzle, a row number and a column number, for that cell that's pointing into it and the cell that is pointing out of it. And those are things that are key to our Numbrix puzzle. So what I've done here is created a new data type in the Python language called a cell. And every cell has all of these attributes associated with it and packaged in with it. And what I've done is I've created default values for what all of these things should be when I create an arbitrary cell object. So if I try to create an object and cast it as a cell data type in Python, all of these values are going to be set to 0, and then these in-cell, out-cell coordinates are going to be set to something that's outside of the puzzle. What I do have the ability to do within a class inside of Python is using this syntax, I can also create an alternative method of creating a data type. And so that's what I'm going to do. In case I want to pass some default values other than what I've put right here when creating a cell. So if I want to create a cell and then pass in both a row number and a column number and the puzzle that I've entered above, I could extract the value and the adjacent values from that puzzle. And so if I pass a row number and a column number and the full puzzle to a cell object when I create it, I can then change the row and the column to match what was passed to me, the value to be the value in the puzzle at that row and column, and then I can peek at the puzzle in these adjacent spots, should that make sense, to occupy the left, right, up, down cell values. So let me just show you what that looks like real quick before we end this video. What I have in the next input cell in my Python document is taking that whole puzzle and creating an object called cells that's going to be exactly the same as the puzzle object, but is going to have every entry in this larger list be of the cell data type. So right here on this line is what I wanted to call your attention to. How do I create an object that I just called X that has the data type of a cell? Well, if I wanted to call it with the default values, I would type X is equal to cell with this empty set of parentheses. But if I wanted to pass it with values that I specify, where it takes that puzzle and is a little smarter, fills in the value and the left, right, up, down cell values, then I call it with this so-called constructor, where I pass in the row that I'm on, I pass in the column that I'm on, and I'm passing the puzzle so that I can fill in all those values to something different.